Hello friends, this video on metals and non-metals part 7 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now let us quickly get into the physical properties of non-metals. Now we are going to discuss exactly the same physical properties which we had discussed for metals. So the first physical property was luster. So in metals we saw that they had a shining appearance, they had a shining surface. But in case of non-metals, they do not have any shiny surface. The best example that you can consider is maybe wood. Wood contains carbon, again coal contains carbon. So a lot of stuffs contain carbon. So if you think of any of these, you can see that they do not have any shiny appearance like gold or silver or copper does. Not sonorous, they do not produce any sort of ringing sound like how metals produce, so you really can't have a bell with wood. Not malleable, not ductile, you definitely cannot. If you start hammering a wood, what will happen? The wood will break into pieces. Similarly, if you start hammering coal, what will happen? It will again break in the form of powders or small pieces. So you will never be able to beat coal or wood or any other non-metal to form a wire or to form a sheet. So they are not malleable, not ductile. Poor conductors of heat. They cannot conduct heat. So they are extremely poor conductors of heat. So if you put, now when you burn coal, they can generate heat. So generating heat is something else. Generating heat means they are producing heat, but they cannot conduct heat. So if you put coal over fire, so the coal will start burning. It will not be able to conduct the heat to some other object. So you really can't cook with a vessel made of wood or with a vessel made of coal. They are also poor conductors of electricity, and that is why your wires are made up of metals and not of wood or coal. Now why I am taking examples of wood and coal, because that is something you can more easily relate to. So you think of a circuit like this, where you have a bulb, you also have a battery. So this is the battery, this is the bulb. Now when you connect the bulb to the battery, these wires are the metal wires, okay? So now the wires are metal wires, so metals are good conductors, but in between you have put a plastic bottle. So this plastic is a poor conductor. Now even though the circuit here is complete, what happens? Now since this plastic is a poor conductor of electricity, so that path of the electric current is not complete and therefore the bulb doesn't glow. So this shows that non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. They are comparatively soft when compared to metals. They have low density. Of course, like you talk about iron or copper, they are extremely heavy, they are very dense, but non-metals are not like that. In fact, when you talk about metals, they are all solids, they are mostly solids. When you talk about non-metals, they are mostly gases or solids. The only exception is bromine, which is a non-metal, but still it is a liquid. Now, so far we have discussed all the physical properties of metals and non-metals, but there are certain exceptions to the physical properties which we have discussed. So let us quickly look at the exceptions. Mercury is the only metal that exists as solid at room temperature. I'm so sorry here, this is not going to be solid because most metals are anyway solid. Mercury is the only metal which is liquid at room temperature. So have you ever observed your thermometers? So inside the thermometer, you see a liquid present, which is kind of shiny, a shiny liquid. And that liquid has a special property that it never sticks to the walls of the thermometer. So that liquid is nothing but mercury. So mercury, otherwise all the metals are solids. So mercury is the only metal which exists as liquid, but still it is a metal. Metals having high melting points, except gallium and cesium. So these are the two metals which have very low melting points, but otherwise metals have high melting points, and that is why they are used for various purposes. Like metals are used in the filaments of bulb, they are used for making utensils, because they will not melt easily. But the exception to that is gallium and cesium. Iodine is a non-metal that has luster. Normally metals have luster, metals have shiny surface, and non-metals do not have luster. But the only non-metal with luster is iodine. Diamond, an allotrope of carbon, is the hardest natural substance known and has a very high melting and boiling point. Now, normally we see that metals are hard and non-metals are soft, but diamond is an exception. Diamond is made up of carbon, but diamond is the hardest substance. So, diamond is harder than all the metals we have spoken about. So, that is one exception. Again, we say that metals have high melting points, but diamond, even though a non-metal, again has high melting point. So that means diamond falls into exception list of two properties. Graphite, which is another allotrope of carbon, is a conductor of electricity. We say that non-metals are poor conductors of electricity, but again graphite is the only exception because it is a good conductor of electricity, but it is a non-metal. Alkali metals like lithium, sodium, potassium are so soft that they can be cut with a knife. They have low densities and low melting points. So these metals, like mostly metals, are hard. That is why when I was talking about the physical properties, I told you that we, based on the physical properties alone, we cannot say whether a substance is a metal or a non-metal, because different metals will behave differently for each of the properties. So therefore, we categorize any substance as metal or non-metal depending upon whether that particular substance is electropositive or electronegative in nature. Now, you look at these metals, lithium, sodium, potassium, they are all metals, but they are not hard. But we say that metals are hard. They also have low densities, but we say metals have high densities. They also have relatively low melting points, but again, we say that metals have higher melting points. So there are quite a few exceptions to the physical properties of metals and non-metals, and these were the ones. Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.